going to be at 7 p.m. The halacha tells us that mayim acharonim, we don't say a brachan. And really, it's a good question, because mayim rishonim, we do say a brachan. So why not say a brachan mayim acharonim? The Gemara says, the Mishnah Berurah, I should say, says that one of the reasons is because why do we do mayim acharonim? So reason number one, melach sedomit. There was a certain type of salt that if it goes into your eyes, it could blind you. And for that, we wash our hands, because that salt was very common during the meal. It's the salt of Sedom. And so it comes, according to that reasoning, if you're washing your hands to remove a potential danger, that's not a reason to say a bracha. There's no positive reason that you're doing it. It's not a positive mitzvah. It's a removal of a danger. And the removal of a danger does not warrant bracha. So that reason doesn't have a bracha. The second reason, which is about the kavod of birkat hamazon, so that your hands are clean for birkat hamazon, inherently would warrant a bracha, because that's out of respect, out of the dignity of the birkat hamazon. So it's a positive command, and therefore it could qualify as something that would require a bracha. However, because of the fact that we don't do it like the original institution, in the times of the Gemara, they would do mayim acharonim, they would use a special type of oil, and then they would do the mayim, the water, and then it was a full mitzvah. Today, the way we do it, it was without the oil, we skip a step. And therefore, the mayim acharonim is not complete, so we're not nohek to say the bracha. At the end of the day, there is no bracha for mayim acharonim, and the halacha says we do it without a beracha. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen v'amen.